Hello, my dear children. Good morning to all. Once again, welcome back to class 11, microeconomics revision classes. So in the last class, we have discussed about the important questions in the fourth chapter. Then today we are going to discuss about the important questions in third chapter, that is producer behavior and supply. So we know that in producer behavior and supply, we have studied about total product, then cost concept, revenue concept, and also the theory of supply. So today we are discussing some important questions related to this producer behavior and supply. So let's start with objective type questions. So first, when TP increases at increasing rate, what happened to MP? Okay, when TP increases at increasing rate, MP, option A, falls, B, rises, C, remain constant, D, all of these. What is the answer? When TP increases at increasing rate, MP rises. Okay, that is the first stage of return to a factor. When TP, total product, increases at increasing rate, marginal product rises. Second question, when MP is more than AP, that is the relationship between MP and MP. When MP is more than AP, AP rises. Okay, that is the correct answer. AP rises. When MP is more than AP, AP rises. Then third question, the time period in which production can be increased by increasing the quantity of variable factor only. Okay, what is the time period? There is only one factor is variable, other factor is fixed. So that time period is known as short period or short run. Okay, so in short run, one factor is fixed, another factor is variable. Okay, so such it is happened only in short period. Then fourth question, production function refers to functional relationship between input and, what is the answer? Choose the correct answer from the option. What is the production function? Production function refers to functional relationship between input and output. Okay, B is the correct answer. The fifth question, total product falls when MP. Total product falls when MP. We have studied law of return to a factor. So in the last stage, the total product falls when MP is negative. Okay, so the total product falls when MP is negative. So D is the correct option. Then the next question, identify the fixed factor in short run. So give an example for fixed factor. So answer for the sixth question is land. Land is a fixed. So rent will give regardless of output. Whether output is zero or other output is increasing, it does not affect the rent, the reward for land, that is rent. Okay, so here the fixed factor is land. Then next question, so long as average product is increasing, when the marginal product is greater than average product. So average product is increasing when marginal product is greater than average product. That is the correct answer. Then when TP curve is upward sloping and convex to x-axis. So what happened to MP curve? MP curve is upward sloping. When TP curve is upward sloping and convex to x-axis, that means TP increasing at increasing rate. So MP curve is upward sloping. Then next, when MC, that's marginal cost, is less than AC. Here is also the relationship between marginal cost and average cost. When MC is less than AC, what happen? AC falls. When MC is less than AC, average cost falls. Then at zero level of output, TC is equal to, at zero level of output, total cost equal to total fixed cost, because if zero level of output, total variable cost is also zero. So total cost is equal to total fixed cost plus total variable cost. So output is zero, total variable cost is zero. So at zero level of output, TC is equal to TFC. Then area under marginal cost curve is, area under marginal cost curve is TVC, marginal cost, because in short run, the additional cost is added to the production only by variable factor or variable cost. So under marginal cost curve is area under marginal cost curve is total variable cost. An example of fixed cost. So can you give an example for fixed cost, or choose the correct answer from the option? Here there cost of raw material, cost of fuel, depreciation of machinery, or D, all of the above. What is the answer? Cost of raw material, that is variable cost, because if there is no production, there is no need for raw material. So there is no cost of raw material. So it is a variable cost. Then cost of fuel. Only fuel is used at the time of production. If there is no production, there is no use of fuel. So it is also a variable cost. Then depreciation of machinery. That is, if whether there is increase in production or there is no production, there is a depreciation of machinery. That means depreciation of machinery is a fixed cost. Okay, it is not depend upon the output. Okay, so depreciation of machinery is the example for fixed cost. So C is the correct answer. Then MC curve cut AC curve at its minimum point. MC curve cuts AC curve at its minimum point. Then identify the variable cost from the following. Identify the variable cost. So in the previous question, there is an example of fixed cost. Then here identify the variable cost from the following. So what is variable cost? It is mainly depend upon the output. If output is zero, variable cost is zero. Then it increases when production increases. Variable cost increases when production increases. So identify the variable cost. Here expenditure on raw material. Expenditure of raw materials is a variable cost. Okay, then expenditure on power, because power is used for, okay, expenditure on power, then expenditure of daily wages, or D, all of these. What is? Yes, the variable cost. All the option A, B, and C are the variable cost. So the answer is D, all of these. All of these are variable cost. Then ALC at 4 unit of output is 20. So AFC at 4 unit of output is 20. ABC at 5 unit of output is 40. So AC of producing 5 unit is, AFC average fixed cost is at 4 unit of output is 20. ABC at 5 unit of output is 40. So what about ACO producing 5 unit average cost? So average cost is equal to fixed cost plus average fixed cost plus average variable cost. Here we having 4 unit of ABC at 4 unit of output, then also ABC at 5 unit of output. So the average cost of producing 5 unit is 56. Next, when AC falls, what happened to MC? When AC falls, MC infinitely falls then rises. Initially it falls and then it rises when AC falls. So when AC falls, MC initially falls then rises. Okay, so that is the answer for this question. The next, demand curve under monopolistic competition. That is, you need not to study about this because it is a deleted portion. That as long as MR is positive, what happened to T? TR increases. When MR is positive, TR increases. Then fifth question is not in the syllabus. Then next question, when a firm sell more at the uniform price, TR increases at constant rate. So option is C. It increases, TR increases at constant rate when a firm sell more at a uniform price. Then when MR rises, TR rises at dash rate. MR rises, TR rises at increasing rate. Okay, when MR rises, TR rises at increasing rate. The eighth question, when 5 units of good are sold, TR is 100. When 6 units are sold, MR is 8. At what price are 6 units sold? At what price the 6 units sold? When 5 units of good are sold, TR is 100. When 6 units are sold, MR is 8. At what price are 6 units sold? So MR is equal to delta TR by delta Q. Okay. So here, or otherwise, MR is equal to TR n minus TR n minus 1. So here, what happened? The answer is rupees 18 per unit. So rupees 18 per unit. Next question, AR and price are always equal under perfect competition only. AR and price are always equal under which market situation? Perfect competition. Then next question, in which form of market is the demand of a firm perfectly elastic? That is in monopoly. Okay, then we are going to the next question. State the behavior of MPP or marginal physical product, or MP, that is marginal product, under return to a factor. Or otherwise, describe about the law of return to a factor or law of variable proportion. It is very important question. So law of return to a factor or law of variable proportion. So what is law of variable proportion? The law says that the marginal product, that is MP, of a factor input initially rises within employment level, but after reaching a certain level of employment, it starts falling. Okay. So state the behavior of MPP under return to a factor. That means state the law of variable proportion or state the law of return to a factor. So according to this law, the marginal product of a factor input initially rises with its employment level, but after reaching a certain level of employment, it starts falling. So you have to draw the diagram also. If it is 6 mark question, you have to draw the diagram and also explain three stages of return to factory. Here you have to explain the three stages of production. That is, first stage, what happened to MPP? In the first stage, MPP initially increases and become maximum. So that is the increasing return to a factor. That is phase, production phase 1. So here TP increasing at increasing rate, MP increases and reach maximum. Okay. Then second one, diminishing return to a factor. Second phase is diminishing return to a factor. In this phase, MPP then decrease positively and becomes 0. Okay, in second stage, that is diminishing return to a factor, MP decreases positively and becomes 0. At the same time, TP increases at decreasing rate and reaches its maximum. Then the last stage, the phase number 3 is negative return to a factor. That is, MPP become negative. In this stage, MPP becomes negative, though TP decreases, start to decrease in this stage. So you have to explain this diagram. You have to draw the diagram and explain the three stages about return to a factor. So it's very important question. Then next, calculate TP from the following data. You can expect this following table filling questions. So here, calculate TP from the following data. So we have already MP here and unit of variable factor here. So how can we calculate MP? What is MP? MP is TPN minus TPN minus 1. Okay. So here MP is given. So in the first case, unit of variable is 1, MP is 20. So the TP is also 20. So in the first stage or first unit, then if unit of variable increased from 1 to 20, marginal product is 80. So what happened to total product? Total product is 20 plus 80, that is 38. Then 38 plus 50, 53. Then 53 plus, 53 plus 0 is equal to 53, and 53 minus 10 is equal to 43. Okay, so TP is MP is TN minus TN minus 1. So if we have MP, we have to add MP. We have to add MP, we will get TP. That is 20 plus 18, 38. Then 38 plus 15, 53. Then 53 plus 0, again 53. 53 plus minus 10. If there is plus and minus, there should be minus. So 53 minus 10, that is 43. Okay. The next question. Define cost of production. So what is cost of production? It refers to the expenditure incurred on input used in the production process. The expenditure of the production is known as cost of production. Then define cost function. What is cost function? It refers to functional relationship between cost and output. So cost is the function of output. And define money cost. It refers to the total money expenses incurred by firm in producing a commodity. So what is explicit cost? It refers to actual payment made to outsider for hiring or purchasing services of the factors of production. That is known as explicit cost. Then implicit cost. It refers to cost of self-supplied or self-owned factor of production, including normal profit. Then what about real cost? It refers to the pain, sacrifice, discomfort and disutility involved in providing factor services required to produce a commodity, that is real cost, the sacrifice of the producer. Then private cost means it refers to cost of production incurred by an individual firm for producing a commodity. So this is all our definition. So you have to study this definition from the textbook or not. So what is opportunity cost? It is the cost of next best alternative use of a factor. Define short run cost. It is a cost spent on fixed factor and variable factor. Then what about the fixed cost? It refers to those costs which do not vary directly with the level of output. That is known as fixed cost. So fixed cost refers to those costs which do not vary directly with the level of output. These are the defined following questions. Then next is, why is total variable cost curve inverse S shape? So what is the shape of total variable cost? It is inverse S shape. So what is the reason? That is TVC is zero at zero level of output. That is total variable cost is zero because it directly vary with output. So if output is zero, TVC also zero. As more unit of output are produced, TVC increased at decreased rate. Okay, so total variable cost, as the more output or production increases, TVC increases at decreasing rate, and later it increases at increasing rate. So at the initial stage, due to the efficiency of variable cost and accuracy, what happened at the initial stage of production? Total variable cost increases at decreasing rate, and later it increases at increasing rate. So the inverse S shape of TVC is because of application of law of variable proportion that we have studied. Law of variable proportion. So what is the cause for inverse S shape of total variable cost? Because of the application of law of variable proportion. Then next, complete the following table. Okay, complete the following table. So here we have output, price, total revenue and marginal revenue. So in the first case, the output is 4, price is given, that is 9. Then total revenue is 36. So marginal revenue is not given. So we have to calculate marginal revenue. So in the first case, the marginal revenue is 0. Then, for calculating marginal revenue, we have to calculate total revenue, then also average revenue. So what is total revenue? Total revenue, here it is 36. Then MR, marginal revenue is nil at first time. So what is AR? We know that in short run, AR is equal to price. So it is 9. Then at the fifth level, it is TR is not given in the questions. So you have find out TR. So if marginal cost is 4, so 36, here the first one 36, so 36 plus 4, 40, that is total revenue. Then 40, then marginal revenue is given, that is 4, and average revenue is equal to what? It is the price of the commodity, that is total revenue divided by output, that is 40 by 5, that is 8. So, in this way, you have to calculate all this. So, here, any one of them will give. So, you have to find out the others according to the question. Then, what changes will take place in MR when TR increases at an increasing rate? Second question, TR increasing at a diminishing rate. And third question, TR increasing at a constant rate. So the answer is MR will increases. TR increases at increasing rate, MR will increases. Then second question, TR increases at diminishing rate, MR will decrease positively. Then TR increases at constant rate, MR is also constant. The next question, why AR curve under monopolistic competition is more elastic than AR curve under monopoly? So you need not to study this question because it is out of syllabus. The next question, what are the reason for shift in supply curve? So the reason for shift in supply curve are change in price of related good, change in price of factor of production, change in state of technology, change in excise tax rate, change in the number of firms. So these are the reason for shift in supply curve. Because what do you mean by shift in supply curve? That is change in increase in supply or increase or decrease in supply due to other factor than price. So what are the other determinants of supply? So these are the other determinants of supply. Change in this factor will leads to shift in supply. Then define price elasticity of supply. It refers to the degree of responsiveness of supply of commodity with reference to the change in price of such commodity. That is percentage change in quantity supply divided by percentage change in price. That is the elasticity of supply, the degree of responsiveness of supply of a commodity with change in price. So this is the elasticity of supply. Then what is the method of measuring price elasticity of supply? There are different methods. We have studied about percentage method, that is by using the formula percentage change in quantity supply divided by percentage change in price. Then also, what are the degrees of price elasticity of supply? The degrees of price elasticity of supply are perfectly elastic supply, perfectly inelastic supply, highly elastic supply, less elastic supply, then unitary elastic supply. So you have to explain, if it is 6 mark question, you have to explain each of them with diagram. Okay. Then what are the factor affecting elasticity of supply? The factor affecting elasticity of supply are nature of the commodity, time period, nature of the input use, cost of production, technical production, natural constraint. That I have given in your notebook. The explanation for each point I have given in the notebook. So you have to study this. The last question, a firm earn a revenue of 50 at the market price of a good at 10. The market price increases to 15 and the firm now earn a revenue of 150. What is price elasticity of firm supply curve? So here revenue means in output. So here the total revenue or a firm earned rupees 50 at the market price of good at rupees 10. So quantity, the old quantity is 50 and old price or initial price is 10. Then market price increased to 50. So rupees 50 is the new price and the firm now earn a revenue of 150. So the new quantity is 150. So what is the price elasticity of the firm supply curve? Here revenue is 150. So total revenue is what? Total revenue divided by price. So here 50 is not the quantity, it is revenue. So how can we calculate quantity? So total revenue divided by price. So 50 by 10, 5. Total revenue quantity is 5. Then here the revenue is 150. So total revenue divided by price is the new quantity. This 150 by 15, that is 10 is the new quantity. So from this we can calculate delta P, that is 15 minus 10, 5. Then delta Q, 10 minus 5, that is 5. Then use the formula P by Q into delta Q by P, that is equal to 10 by 5 into 5 by 5, that is equal to 2. So price elasticity of supply is equal to 2. Okay, so these are the important questions. So you have to study it well. Thank you, students. See you in the next tuition class. Bye.